He is appearing at the comic strip at West Edmonton Mall opening tonight, running for three nights. He joins us in studio here at Capital FM. Tom Green.
All right.
Welcome back, man.
All right. Great to be here. Edmonton. Yes, good to be back in Edmonton. Man, this was the first stop of my tour.
Yeah, you kick off, and you've been busy for like a year and a half.
Yeah, I've been going all over the place, and it's great to be back where it all started.
Where did that? All of a sudden, the microphone just dropped off.
Oh yeah, is my mic off? Oh, did I break it? Did
I would,
break,
I broke oh, you broke it.
I broke the microphone.
Here, use this one.
Okay,
I'll move over
okay.
here.
Yeah, oh, there we go. Okay. Oh, hello. I'm on your microphone now. Here oh, now you use that microphone. We're all switching. You should see what's going on here, everybody. On the radio, we're switch. It's Mike. We're switching microphones.
We're doing musical.
We're playing
mics.
The microphone switching game.
Yeah.
No, it's cool. It's cool. I've had a fun time touring around and. I'm getting a weird echo in the headphone too.
Yeah,
I'm just gonna take the headphones off.
It's okay.
Yeah, there's a lot of technical stuff we're talking about. Yeah. We don't need to talk about the technical stuff, right?
No. But you were just in Afghanistan too. Entertaining the troops.
I was. Yeah, I've literally gone all over the world, literally everywhere in the last year since I was here, and I had a great trip to Afghanistan. Went with the Canadian Defense Department. Mm-hmm. And flew over there to Kandahar and did a show for Canadian-U.S. Coalition forces in Kandahar and had an amazing experience over there. It was pretty awesome. You know, went over there with a whole bunch of NHL legends, too. Tiger Williams, Lanny McDonald, and Pierre Bourque, and a whole bunch of guys.
So, yeah.
We actually flew out to some of the forward operating bases out in the
Did you have to put the suit, the whole, you know, the
flak
jacket
flak
on?
Jacket yeah, right. and yeah. helmet, and we flew out in the Chinook helicopters, Canadian Chinook helicopters, flew out to some of these forward operating bases, FOBs, right, out in the middle of Afghanistan. So it was very surreal, but it was a privilege to be able to do it, honestly. It was a real great experience, and was happy to be able to go over there, so... Yeah,
did you see any action, or were you near any of the action?
Didn't really see any. There was a rocket attack. There was a rocket attack on the base, and we had to take cover. The siren went off. We took cover, and that was pretty exciting. Yeah,
I could hear the sound of your sphincter just closing.
Yeah,
when you hear the
did
siren,
you hear that?
Yeah.
Did you hear? I've been trying to get that fixed.
Wasn't that Tim's sphincter? Bob's sphincter?
Yeah. No, I hope that didn't translate through the radio, because that would be not the way you want to wake up in the morning.
No.
But, speaking of Afghanistan, you were quoted in the Huffington Post. You were the first to tweet about the whole Osama bin Laden story.
Oh, did they finally come around and mention it in the Huffington Post?
Yeah, I saw a link on it.
Oh, really?
The other day.
Today? Yeah, because it's something I'm quite, proud of. You know, I took broadcasting in school, you know. I consider
no,
myself...
No, he did.
Yeah,
really.
I like to consider myself a journalist. I do a web television show.
Right.
On my website. It's the longest running internet talk show. And I was the first... Therefore, because I do a television show in my living room, therefore you could argue that I'm a member of the media, right?
Right.
And because of that, I was the first member of the media to report the death of Osama bin Laden, the biggest story in journalism, let's say in, what, the last half century?
Oh, easily.
Possibly. Yeah.
Of at least this century.
Yeah. So, you know, there you go. So, I mean, I tweeted it before CNN. I tweeted it to my followers. If you can follow me on Tom Green Live, at Tom Green Live, before anybody in the media. Everybody's saying The Rock tweeted it first. The Rock didn't even mention it.
The Rock.
Really? Everyone's saying The Rock. No, The Rock at 10:24. Okay, The Rock tweeted, "I'm proud to be an American. Something's going on," but he didn't say what. How's that reporting?
That's just.
He just said something's going on, but I'm not telling you what it is.
Yeah.
That's not reporting.
No.
It's like, imagine if the Walter Cronkite came on after the guy landed on the moon, whatever his name was, and he said, yeah, something happened, but I'm not going to tell you what it is.
Yeah, right there.
You'll find out about it later.
Sure.
So how did you know it was Osama being dead, though? Like, how did you go?
Well, you know, I'm very susceptible to a lot of internet chatter. I get a lot of internet chatter. So because I was online at the time, and I've been doing so much stuff on the web over the years, I started hearing, I have two sources that came to me that mentioned this. The news actually was first tweeted by a White House aide, okay,
right.
Not a member of the media though, an insider, right? Tweeted it at 10:24, and then by 10:26 or 10:27, I reported it. Reported it.
Okay, so did you kind of like retweet?
I just basically, what happened was I deduced it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I deduced it.
You'll be on Fox by this time.
Because I read a few people mentioned that something was going on, and I turned on CNN, and the breaking news was the president was making an unannounced speech, but nobody knew why.
Right.
And then I said, Osama bin Laden is dead.
There it
right?
is.
Wow.
There
you
go.
And you made history. A Canadian.
Yeah. I made history. I'm very excited about this. No, I'm just kind of excited, to be honest with you, that, I think it's a good thing. I think that maybe we can move on in our world now and start worrying about other stuff. We don't have to go through the, apparently we don't have to take our shoes off at the airport anymore. We don't have to go right. through the metal detectors anymore.
You can take the shampoo on board now?
Yeah.
Or?
Yeah. Isn't that what's happening? Isn't it over now? Isn't
the war over?
The
troops will be coming back from Afghanistan.
The war is over now,
the world is
safe. I thought the war was over now.
Of course.
Yeah.
That'll
no
be
more metal
that'll
detectors.
Be your next tweet.
Yeah.
That'll be your next tweet.
The war is over. I should have tweeted that.